So I've attached some 16-aught tan thread to this hook shank. It's a little bit longer shanked hook, just so I can use two different examples here. So I've got in my hand here a little clump of elk hair. And one of the things that I noted in the post above is that a lot of the pictures that I see try to come in with just simply too much elk hair. So I know there's some patterns like stimulators and those sorts of things where you're going to use a lot. But a lot of times with elk hair caddis, and other small, more petite patterns, you really don't need a whole lot. So when you get these big clumps here, I've got thread underneath there, but when you get just way too much hair, it tends to clump, your amount of your tension's a little bit reduced, and it likes to roll and move back and forth. So be super, super careful on the amount of hair that you use there. Tying rule that has always, always benefited me is less is more, without a doubt. So if I bring in another clump here, I've just kind of finger stacked this stuff. I know you can use big hair stackers if you're doing large quantities. For small stuff like dries, I like to just cut out the little bit that I need, turn it upside down, tap it on the palm of my hand to even out those tips. So if I come forward here, a lot of times like at the front of an elk hair caddis, we tie in our stuff, we tie off the hackle, and then there's always a little bit of open bare hook shank. And we talked about, because of the fact that this hook shank's so smooth, that if you don't lay down a few nice thread wraps, doesn't have to be a huge buildup of thread, but just at least a few nice side-by-side wraps, it doesn't allow that friction to build up, and friction is helpful in that situation. So that way, when I go to tie this in, as I wrap back over the top of it, I have thread wraps under there, and that thread wrap's going to increase the friction, and it's going to help bind and hold that in place where I want it. Last thing, and always a huge thing for me, you know this well, if you've seen my clips and my videos, is the sake of durability. So if this was the front end of a little emerger or an elk hair caddis, I'm going to come in with just a little bit of Zappa Gap, and I'm going to glaze the top of that on the tie-in point, and I'm going to also come underneath and get that right where it touches on the hook shank. Those two things are really, really helpful as far as just increasing the longevity of the fly on the water, especially once you start to get into fish.